Hi friends, today let us discuss a block called pulse generator. This is a very important block for power electronic applications where power electronic switches are used. So the power electronic switches means it's basically a switch, so it has to switch on and it has to switch off. So that pattern will be given by the pulse generator. Now let me open an MDL file. So this is my Simlink library. So this is, I need to open this and I will open a new file. So this is a new model. So let me make it bigger. And this one is my library. Yeah. Here I like to take the pulse generator. The pulse generator is under Simlink sources. This is the pulse generator. And I need to see the pattern, so definitely I should have a scope here. Yeah, this is the scope. Now double click on pulse generator. Let us see what are the things in pulse generator. So the pulse generator amplitude is 1, so the topmost thing will be 1, so it is from 0 to 1, so obviously the amplitude is 1. And the period means up to what cycles the period the pulse has to repeat. That means, for example, if we are using it for single phase supply and 50 hertz supply, then we need to take seconds. We need to take the frequency into seconds. That means 1 by 50 is equal to 0.02 seconds. So we need to write 0.02 seconds here. And pulse width is okay, 5% of the period. Okay, no problem. And coming to this is a phase delay. Phase delay is here, we need to mention the time such that the pulse has to start at that point only. And that will obviously tell us the alpha firing angle. But now I like to explain a little bit more about this by using paint. Okay, let me draw this line with this maybe dark line. Hope it is understood. See, this one is my pulse, 5% of pulse, and this is complete other thing. Of course, this line is a straight line. Don't feel that it's something different. Like this, and this is the thing, and I have started here. Just see, this is my 0.0th point and this is my pulse, complete pulse, and from that point to this point, this is my total cycle. Okay, this thing is repeatedly I am getting this pulse. Now see what are the parameters we need to give it, and we need to give the parameters like this. The parameters are this one, amplitude. So this part is my amplitude, and this is amplitude. So the first parameter, amplitude, and the second one is time period. So the time period, as you know, the time period is first upper peak to upper peak, or lower peak to lower peak, or some point to some other point, which is repeated. So I am taking this black one as this is my time period. This is time period. So let me go to this part once again and what exactly it is. Yeah, amplitude and period. Period means time period only, and this is in seconds. Next, pulse width. Let me show you what is pulse width is meant by. The pulse width is this part. What is this part? This part in percentage of the other, percentage of this one, from this point to up to that point only, like this. So this is 5% or 10% or 50%, that's up to you. That according to the system you can give it, but here we have used 5%, so this is the percentage, so I can call it as this is percentage of the period. Let me see in which way he has given. This is pulse width. Yeah, this one is called pulse width. That will be in percentage of period. So I can call it as pulse width will be in percentage of total period. So this is the total period. So here you can observe one thing, the black one and the blue one, both are same. Why? Because they are time period. So that's why this one is considered in pulse width. It should be percentage of period or percentage of time period. And the fourth point is, yeah, this is phase delay. This one is very, very important point, and this part is called, denoted as phase delay. This one is phase delay. Yeah, this is phase delay. According to this only, we can find the alpha. We can provide alpha to power electronic switches. For example, see, if this is the total time period and the pulse delay is some x, for example, if the pulse delay is some x and this is time period, if x is directly give you the alpha value in second, that's what the thing is. For example, if I want to take 45 degree here, okay, 45 degree means, let me come here, 45 degree should represent x, and here 360 degree will represent the total time period. So 360 will represent total time period. So what will happen? What is the time period for 50 hertz? For 50 hertz, the time period is 0.02 seconds. So let me write simply 45 by 360 divided by 45 by 360 is equal to x divided by time period, where the time period is, for 50 hertz, it will be 0.02 seconds. So this is the thing. So we can cut this 45, how many times it will go? If it is 90, it should be 4, and if it is this one, it should be 8. So it will be 8 times. So I can cut this into one more time, 0.01 divided by 4. So I can write simply x is equal to 0.01 divided by 4. So it will be 0.0025 seconds. So this is a simple calculation of x is taken as 45 degree or alpha is taken as 45 degree. These two are in degrees like this. Okay, let me verify all these things in our simulation. Let me open this. This is one. Okay, its period 0.02 seconds. It's 5% only. Delay is taken as 0.0025, and now it will be okay. Now need to connect to this, that's it. And here I need to change this to some 0.1, so that it can give us 5 seconds, and I can simply simulate it so that the answer will be like this. See, this is the answer. Okay, for clarity, we can change axis properties here. Let me change axis properties from minus 2 to plus 2. Apply. Okay, so this is the thing. See, here up to 0.02, this one is one cycle for us. For sinusoidal, it is complete cycle. Like this, cycle will be like this. So 0.02 is 360 degree. 0.01 is 180 degree, and 0.005 will be 90 degree, and this will be exactly 0.0025. Let me show that also. Yeah, this will be like this, exactly 0.025. It is 2.5 millisecond. So this is what we call as the pulse generation. And these pulses will be given to the thyristor. So the thyristor will on accordingly, and this will be directly used in our rectifier circuits and inverter circuits also. So let us discuss those things in the next video. And if anyone is not subscribed till date, so please subscribe to our YouTube channel and please like this video and try to write comments. If you have any doubts, just write in the comments. If I committed any mistake, kindly let me know, and please share this video with your friends. Thank you. Thank you one and all.